to hear him on the train while I'm walking the cell down. I'm just impressed by my own song choosing abilities, that part. Congratulations.
Look at my forehead. Nice. Nice. We like what you're doing out there. I know I'm going to delete this tomorrow, so I should probably just stop it right now. No, actually, I got an idea. My idea is that I could make a video. I could skip ahead, or I could just tell you the songs I chose. See, here's what usually happens. Usually there's too much money in there, and I never stay long enough to hear what I played. But this time, it's my $5. All these people that are at the pool tournament have to listen to the music I chose. I started out with the classic, You Shook Me All Night Long. See, the way it goes is that she's a fast machine. She keeps her motor clean. She's the best damn woman that he'd ever seen. She had sightless eyes telling him no lies, knocking him out with those sightless eyes. Let's just say it was a good date. It was such a good date, he wrote a song about it. He's been trying to live up to it ever since, but I think he died. Is this the first guy or the second guy at AC/DC? There have been two guys. I think that's the first guy. No, that's the second guy. They got big after the first guy. They got big with the second guy. Wait, how many guys? Yeah. There's like three guys that remember this song. That's not Lover Boy. What the hell did I play? That's a wannabe Lover Boy. Oh, it's a cover. That's a cover band. That's pretty lame. That's what happens when you pick songs without wearing your glasses. Look, in the fifth grade, I was in a band for about 6 weeks. We were gonna play Loverboy working for the weekend. I claimed I was able to play keyboards, but I could not. But it turned out we didn't do it, so it worked out. Sorry, guys. Hi, Kevin.
Okay?
Yeah.
I'm doing okay because what these people don't know is that I'm out of money. I got money at home though. This reminds me to get off my ass and bill my customers. When I get home, I'm gonna like use the Shazam and find out who this is. If this turns out to be the original Loverboy and I just don't remember the song, that could be. I'm a little bitter, you know, my dad wouldn't let me go to the Loverboy concert in the fifth grade either. Who was opening for Cheap Trick. I believe it was Loverboy and Cheap Trick in the fifth grade. He's like, no, you're not old enough to go to a concert, but all my friends are going, well, you know, if all your friends wanted to jump off a cliff, would you jump off your cliff? It's like, yeah, if it's a Loverboy concert, they get to go to a concert, why don't I get to go? So the next chance I had to go to a concert, I'd already graduated high school, 18 years old. I saw Motley Crue after they were over, and Whitesnake after they were over. Nice. Bye, Kevin. Dennis, Kevin. Kevin. I get Dennis and Kevin mixed up. There is no Dennis. There's just Kevin. I don't know why I want to call him Dennis. I still think if you originally played the song, you should be able to gong the song. I guess they don't know who put the $5 bill in there. I'm still claiming that a jukebox, you ought to be able to go up and pay a dollar to stop the song. Once we get to the cashless society and we all belong to our masters, they can put the credit back on our account. If someone wants to stop the song, they can pay $2 and you get a dollar of it. Yeah, that's not Loverboy. That's bad. That's a digital reproduction of an 80s synthesizer. That's bad. This, however, is actually Safety Dance. They're having a pool tournament here. Safety Dance has got to be a bad addition to that. Well, you're welcome. You didn't let me play. No, I didn't know there was a pool tournament. I was up there. I'd already paid my dollar. I was sitting at the pool table. They said, hey, we're going to take your pool table from you, but we'll get you a dollar. They did give me a dollar. Oh yeah, they're looking around now wondering who played this. They know it's me. You're welcome, Jerry. Your favorite song. You're welcome, buddy. I'm happy to play what you like, Jerry. He didn't ask for this. I played this because I thought it was good. This song's twice as old as The Bartender. It's easier to line up the shots when you're listening to this. You were a baby. You were a baby when this came out. 55. No shit, really? Oh, okay, Jerry's outliving me. Jerry's looking a lot younger year for year than I am.
Jerry looks just like he did 20 years ago.
I was going to say he was like maybe 48, 47. Way to go, Jerry. We like what you're doing out there. That's probably because Jerry works hard. We're almost in my $5 and we'll be out here. No, I'm doing this live thing on my YouTube channel. Yeah. No, I played this, and I'm just making fun of that you picked it, because if people don't like it, I want to blame it on you.
Oh, fine. Okay, they like it or not. But I play the ones I want. I remember all this.
Yeah. 58. Right? No, this is, I can't remember his name. It's the same time that David Bowie got big, though. Safety Dance. Who did Safety Dance? Hurry! Man without hats. That's a man without hats.
I don't even know this guy.
I was kidding. Joe.
I don't know. I'm thinking of going to turn it. Is
this your wife? Mine's her.
Oh, my husband's over there.
I wasn't working on
it. I work for her.
Oh, okay.
That's my husband, that's my boyfriend.
Is he bar boyfriend? No, I wasn't hitting on him, that's all right. I don't want to get into trouble here.
Okay, Jerry's going to play good music now. I can whistle, but I got to do it through my teeth. What I was saying is, for the pool tournament here, they need a loudspeaker or some kind of scoreboard that shows who's winning so we can follow along and get excited about it. All I see is a bunch of pool. It looks about like it does when all the pool tables are busy. I don't know the stakes, though. You know, like, do I need to know that Doug over there, you know, if he's out, if he doesn't, I know if he doesn't win this one, he's out, because that's the way this tournament works. If you lose, you're out.
four tables. There's about 100 people trying to play on four tables. No, there's like 21 people. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, there's 12 people. No. There's got to be an even number of people per table. 12 divided by 4 is 3 people per table. That doesn't make any sense. Unless they go around multiple times. This math is not making sense. What we're working up to, secret, is Die Antwoord. What's bizarre is I didn't recognize the singer of this song. I mean, I had to look at it like 3 times, so I guess I never learned the name of this song, the guy who sang the song. I just knew the song. This is the part where I stare right at. Ow! That's gotta be way better. That way I can't look at you. Well, it must be shutting down. One of the tables isn't busy. Either that or you don't have to compete until the end of time.
Did I put the microphone down on the wrong side? Hi.
Hi. We like what you're doing out there. We're going to give you a nostril shot. We sure hope that this ended up on teddybear.com automagically. What I did is I embedded the feed from the channel. That makes me try to make it count because I'm driving around with a car that says teddybear.com, and if I'm driving around with a car that says teddybear.com, you want people to see something that's worthwhile when they go to teddybear.com. Just not my latest sad video about wasps or an ex-wife or two. Well, I'm sorry, I only have one ex-wife. I've been married since 2008, but I haven't seen her since 2008. Yeah, it's sick. My dad was thrilled. Okay. If you're just catching up, we're shocked that Jerry is 58. He's per capita beating me on the young looking. I was going to put him at 48 or something. Anyway, Jerry and I, we figured out that we're both about the same kind of pool player, that when we enter a pool tournament, it's a donation to the pool tournament purse. Right now, a guy with an Australian hat is taking a shot on the 5. Oh, not looking good. A difficult leave. It's a difficult leave, doctor. The guy I'm calling Doug, but I can't remember his name, looks like he's in a commanding position here to win this game. That's right. I played rap, but it's Eminem. Does that count? Does that count? What happened was the guy I'm calling Doug made a shot on the 8, but it double kissed and then went in. But I don't know about the tournament rules, whether or not that counts. I think it does count because you went in the pocket that you called, so it should count. I used to be a stickler for the rules, but I can't remember the rules. And a lot of our games, if you don't call certain things, did you never call a double kiss? I think he won. That was a win. That was a win. It was a win because the game's over. Speaking of, as I said, I am married. I haven't seen Tracia, a.k.a. Nikki Starr, since 2008. We've been married 30 days when she moved to Minnesota, Mankato, Minnesota. This is one of her favorite songs. She taught me to love rap. I guess it's winding down. Oh, yeah. Okay. They're going again. It's the next round. If you'll remember, at the MTV whatever Rock Music Awards, they did the real Slim Shady thing, and he came out, and there were a whole bunch of lookalikes that had T-shirts just like him, and they were running through the crowd. It was very exciting. The real reason I know about it is because Tracia had me watch it. Tracia. Call me. Yeah. I mean, I suppose one positive side effect of being married so long and so lost is that if I really want to get married again, it's a paperwork process. There's a divorce involved. The only reason I put it off is because it's going to cost money. Yeah. Because I don't have a phone number or anything. Like I said, Tracia, call me. We'll get you the divorce we both deserve. But if you don't, that's cool too. So why did Tracia move to Mankato, Minnesota? 30 days after we were married. Well, we'd been together 3 years at that point. Let's see. The area supervisor one time when they came to our apartment said, as I was sitting in the front of his police car, he said, look, you two need to split up or one of you is going to end up killing the other. That's not the reason we split up, but she did move away just a few days later. I don't know. 90 days later. She's having a grandbaby, and her daughter knew that we should split up, and her daughter used that leverage to say, hey, you want to see your grandbaby? You got to move up here, and you got to leave him there, and that's what happened. Did I take that line down? Well, mostly, but a couple months later, I did show up in Mankato, Minnesota. And had to be run out of town, and the sheriff drove me to Iowa, dropped me off at a casino, and said, "Hey, you stay here. Don't come back." Looking around, yeah, Jerry played this one too. Jerry's not claiming this one. Okay, I played it. That is Die Antwerps. They're from South Africa. They can duck down real low and nobody will know I played it. It's a great song, though. The guy I'm calling Doug has almost won yet another game. Oh, nope, I'm wrong. Doug's behind on this game. I should know his name. I heard it the other day. I met him the other day. This is the last song I played. And then we're going to hear what Jerry played. What would happen if I put the glasses on you, Doctor? Oh,
Diane, where it is a couple out of South Africa. It's your standard, probably bullshit rap story. Life of crime, found music, and now they make music. A lot of their music is in Afrikaans, which is a language out there. It's some kind of Creole type language in South Africa. This is the best part where he says, jump, motherfucker, jump, 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 motherfucker, jump, 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 motherfucker, jump. Motherfucker, jump. I mean, she's good, too. And they're a funny couple because she's like 5 feet tall and he's 7 feet tall or something. He's some crazy 6'5 or something. They have a, well, I mean, I haven't known what's going on with them for a few years, but they had a kid that has some crazy name, probably not a real name, that they announced to the world. Speaking of crazy names, Moon Zappa, you need to call me. What are you doing out there? Moon Unit. I'm willing to call you by your full name. Call me Moon Unit. I'm a couple years older than you, but I think we get along. Men without hats. Okay, Jerry picked this. He wins. No fair. It was probably on the list. I could have picked this. Thanks. Good night.
Hey, you know you record some stupid videos to watch, especially on my channel and especially on YouTube. Appreciate you tuning in to this one. Could you please squeeze the notification bell? Possibly click the like. Move my face away from the camera. Good night.